This week on Outdoor Junkies, we will be joining Walt Matan and Jesse Quale on the Wisconsin River for pre-spawning walleyes.
Live action.
Junkie style.
This is awesome.
Check her out, boys. What a beautiful fish. Look at this thing.
Oh, yeah!
Junkie style, baby.
That is sweet.
Outdoor Junkies!
Walt and Jesse are preparing the boat to head out at one of the many boat launches on the Wisconsin River in the Greater Mauston area.
We're out here in Petenwell and do a little early spring walleye fishing. The ice has just broken up. Walleye should be snapping, should be having a good day.
Good.
It's the end of March and the walleyes are just starting to head up the Wisconsin River to spawn below the dam.
What's this, frozen foam?
Yeah.
Wow.
As they head up the Wisconsin River to jockey for position, they can't help but notice all of the other boats.
Well, right now I got a 5/16 ounce H2O jig with a oyster shell pulsar. No minnow yet. A lot of times they'll nibble on them minnows, but they'll really smack the plastic in this early season.
Seems like the bigger fish are coming on plastic.
Yeah. On plastic, that's what we go for. Pulsar's made by BFish and tackle. It's authentic plastic. It's got a little tail here. It's got a lot of action on this tail. So even when you're not moving it,
first cast,
first fish. Look at that.
13
incher.
All right. Yeah, maybe.
It doesn't take long, and the first fish is in the boat.
Up on the stinger.
Yep. This little fat male. A lot of these up here right now.
It's a slot here for keepers.
They gotta be 15 inches to keep. And then from 20 to 28, no harvest, and then one over 28. And then it's five walleyes total.
Live action.
No. Well, got a little more pull to it now. But it's a river though.
A little bigger than the little saugers we were getting yesterday.
Yeah, a little bigger than the saugers we were getting yesterday.
Nice one there. Good eater too. Nice male. Put that one.
Yeah. 18 and a half.
Yeah, I threw out that way and started drifting about three quarters way down and all of a sudden just slammed it.
Want to keep that one, Mike?
What's that?
Want to keep that one?
Yeah.
Stay tuned.
Outdoor Junkies is brought to you by I-90 Enterprises, Hangsters Motorsports, Custom Jigs and Spins, Grandpa Ray Outdoors, Clark's Resorts and Outposts, Greater Mauston, and these fine sponsors. This has been a Stone Lake production. This segment is brought to you by Plot Hog. Join the food plot revolution at plothog.com.
Welcome back to Outdoor Junkies. The guys are fishing in depths from 5 to 15 feet using BFish and tackle plastics and jigs with minnows with water temperatures of 42 degrees. The live bait's working well, but the guys are going to switch over to plastics to try and target bigger fish.
I'm going to switch over to plastic now. Seems like a lot of you get numbers of fish. You get legals too, but with the live bait, switch over to plastics.
I fished the very first MWC with Poppy.
That was moons ago.
Yep. We were in a 16-foot smoker craft, big fisherman, and we were fishing, I think, in like 30 foot of water. and we got Gary Roach on our right side. We had Bob Props and Mike McClelland on our left side. They ended up first and second place, and we were in the middle, and Poppy was fishing with the Zebco 33, a push button jig fishing in 30 feet of water. And Gary Roach goes to him, he goes, "Nice reel, Poppy." And he goes, "Oh yeah, I like it. I like this one."
So we've been getting them on below the delves too lately. Most of the fish have been on plastic. Fingers cold?
Yeah.
So is mine.
One finger tip. There we go.
That one pounded that plastic. First cast of the plastic and he hammered it. This one feels a little bit bigger too. There we go. This might be net worthy. On the purple. First cast on the purple.
Nice one.
Very nice.
Another 18.
Yeah. About a 17, 18 incher. We don't like to keep all any of the females, and this one looks like a bigger female, so we're gonna put this one back. We'll keep a bunch of males today. We go belly on her. A couple weeks down the road, she won't be like that.
Nope.
Nice one to put back. Choom, gone.
For the old fish sandwich, since you let that one go.
Finally got one. It's a good one. You know why? Because I caught it. No, it's actually a seriously good one. I don't know. It's pulling like a fish.
It's a good one. That one popped the card too. They want it aggressive.
Don't let me down, Mike. Don't let me down.
I like that purple, man.
Yeah, that could be too. Well, it's purple.
Is it purple?
Purple's hot.
It could be purple. Yep. 14 and a half. But it did smack it, and it smacked it on the drop, just like you said.
That's another good one.
Classic.
Try a 14.
It's going to be 14.
Hey, I'm on the board. No, I'm not.
Are you on the board when you catch a small one?
Yeah. Oh, okay. Lifted.
Catch when you're on the board.
I'm on the board then.
14 and 3/4.
Close.
Yeah, almost.
Kind of a funky color combination, but that purple tail is really, really good. They're hammering that harder than they are the minnow.
Good eater, 18. Throw that back there, bud.
Yeah, jigdos, if you're pitching a plastic, work it really, they're really aggressive. They're hitting it on the fall.
Drag him through that foam, Mike.
I'm going to. Pull it up right now.
Good one, Mike.
No, it's still a lot of head shaking. It's not a walleye.
Walleye.
No, it's not a walleye.
Yeah, it is.
No, it's not. Nah, it's doing a lot of head shaking. No, it's not.
It's a good walleye.
It's a big walleye.
It is. I don't know.
I don't know.
It's exactly what you called a while ago.
Brown trout?
The brown trout.
The brown trout.
Look at that. So what's the story with these, Jesse?
I say, I didn't think of the walleye. A lot of head shaking.
There it is. The trout stream not too far from here, and that's where he come out of.
Huh. We'll do the trout release.
There you go.
There
he's
goes.
A slimy booger.
Got a little, can I wipe bite on the camera there?
stay tuned for more Junkie action.
This segment is brought to you by Hangsters Motorsports.
Hangsters Motorsports is now the fastest growing Yamaha dealer in the state of Wisconsin.
For more information, go to hangstersmotorsports.com.
So what's going on, Walt?
Not a whole lot right now. A lot of boats, a lot of fishermen, a lot of sneaky fish. Right now I got a ringworm on with an H2O jig, 5/16 ounce jig. And what you want to do is you want to cast out cross current and you snap it and then it kind of tumbles down. And a lot of times that last spot behind the back of the boat, the final swing, is where you'll get one. So you never want to reel it in too quick. So I'm going to show you some of the jigs and lures that we use in the springtime from BFish and Tackle that work really well on walleyes and also white bass. Basically what we've got two different kinds of jigs. We've got the H2O jig, and what's nice about the H2O jig is it's got a good wire keeper that holds your plastic in place, ultra sharp mustad hook, comes in a variety of colors, and we got the weight stamped right on the bottom here. So this one here is a 3/16. So if you're out fishing with a bunch of guys and you're using a 3/16, it's real easy just to grab one. Well, it's 3/16, know what it is. We've got a 32nd, we've got them all up to 5/8 of an ounce. So there's a lot of different sizes, a lot of different colors. H2O jig cuts real good through the river, whether you're fishing with plastic or whether you're fishing with a minnow. You also have the dragon jig, and the dragon jig got a wedge-shaped head. It's got a real good fiber weed guard, and this'll dig through the rocks, dig through the weeds, dig through a brush. It's not gonna get snagged up. Works really well, cuts through current. Just a real good all-around jig when you're fishing in heavy cover. If you're walleye fishing in the spring or even white bass fishing, good blade bait, like silver is good, gold's a good color, but the B3 blade bait works real well. You can either vertical jig it up and down or cast it out shallow and reel it back slowly. Authentics, the first plastic that we came out with was the ringworm. Everybody knows what a ringworm is, but ours have a little bit bigger rings. We've got them in a variety of colors, lots of different color tails. We've got a moxie, which has got even bigger rings and a bigger tail. So when the fish are aggressive, and especially at night, this glow color that we just came out with is killer for these walleyes. Another top bait is the Pulsar. Pulsar's got that big beefy body, but it's got a pulsating tail that in the slowest of current, whether you're jigging or moving it or not, this tail is always moving, attracting the fish. These are all really great lures that we've had success with in the early spring and actually throughout the year for walleyes and white bass. For more information or to check out these jigs for yourself, just go to bfishandtackle.com. There, Mike's got one. That one, Mike?
All right.
Good one?
Can't tell. It's a river.
I got one.
That's a small one.
Yeah, small one. It was a bite though we had.
He's close.
Next year.
I don't know.
14?
Seems like some
of
them.
Yeah, probably 14.
Some of them just don't throw.
They
just
stay, right?
They all stay right there.
14 and 7/8. 14 and 7/8.
Yep. I'm going to pull out all this stuff, so I'm going to use the Doug method. Ooh, look at that. That's a nice one there. You stole my minnow.
Sleep was hungry.
Yep.
Good, he slammed it. new rig. Alright, we're gonna move locations here. The fish kind of shut off. I think we might actually jump either go down river or go up on top a little bit, but we'll be right back.
Maybe.
stay tuned for more Junkie action. This segment is brought to you by I-90 Enterprises, your benchmark for excellence. Welcome back to Outdoor Junkies.
So we're back. We moved a little farther north in another spot, and you can see there's a whole lot of fishermen out here too. So hopefully we're going to catch a few more fish on ringworms and other plastics and maybe a little jig and minnow too. There we go, on a ringworm. It's a fish. Let's just say I've had a fish for a while, so I'll say it's a good fish
for me.
Well, any, that one, Mike?
Any fish is a good fish. Yeah.
Oh yeah, that's a good one, dude.
Yeah.
What you want to do is net it so it doesn't fall off.
There you go.
Oh, we broke the ice.
Look at that.
I knew I was here for a reason.
I know they were there for a reason, exactly. This one hit a nice bright.
The last bite he had was about 9:15 this morning.
Nice bright H2O jig with a.
Sounds about familiar.
A ringworm there.
Measure that one.
I measured, but it is. It'll be 14 7/8.
It's in there,
touching. He's 15.
It's touching.
Oh yeah. He's over.
Oh, no. We got a legal.
Oh. The first legal of the spring.
We even put a brown trout on the board.
There you go. Thank you.
There you go.
It's a miracle.
That's what we had 32.
I did everything right that time.
Yes, you did.
I don't know what I did, though.
That's Firecracker Chartreuse tail, isn't it?
It is. No, it's Goldcracker Chartreuse tail. That's what it is, a Goldcracker. So many colors, I can't even keep up.
See, it's from Superman earlier.
Yeah. We just moved and gotten a little bit of a deeper hole. And this one, it was just resting on bottom when this fish took it. This feels like a good one. I'll tell you what.
Feels like a fat girl.
Yeah.
Ooh, there's a good one.
There we go. All right. That's what we're talking about.
You need your whole mouth there, Walt.
Yep.
I told you he could catch one.
Yeah,
he engulfed
it. Yep, he engulfed. I said he just took it right from the bottom.
Well, you should have seen it on the bottom, though, because the bottom, like right behind the wave of that bottom, you could see where the fish were sitting right in that blank spot.
Really?
16.
But the one thing about when you're fishing plastics, you definitely want to be more aggressive than when you're walleye fishing.
Almost like you're snap jigging.
Yep, snap jigging. And it's usually on the fall, and then when you go pick up again is when the fish is on.
It's not that big, but there we go.
Finally. Color must be the one. Might as well get the net. It'll be legal again if you get the net. Oh, it's not legal. But it's gonna
he's close.
It's close. Go ahead. Might as well. Well, I don't want to get stuck.
It's a rubber net. It won't be stuck.
Look at that.
This one's not going to make it, though.
I'll bump him.
I will. It's a... Look at that guy. He's posing for the camera.
Three casts.
Oh, that one's probably 14 and a quarter.
Oh, it's a 16. Oh, I can go to the tip. It's 14 and a quarter. Yep. Well, 14 and a quarter don't count.
Thank you.
Nice looking fish, though.
Yep, good looking fish. Healthy fish.
There you go.
She's gonna jump, Mike. She's gonna jump. It's gonna be short. Yep, ringworm. Yep.
No, mine's catalpa. Yep. Purple.
Little 12 incher there. But he fought like a 13 incher. Hey, we had a great day out here, Jess. Thanks for taking me out.
You bet, thanks. Yeah, the fishing started out, you know, pretty hot and heavy right away this morning and slowed down throughout the day, but we got a few more keepers in the box.
Some
more shorts.
Yep.
That's how it goes. Yep. It'll change here. Water's starting to warm up. You know, we got a good current flow. It'll happen. The next week and a half will be pretty good.
Yep. Well, if you're interested in coming up here, you can contact Jesse Quale at
greenwaterwalleyes.com.
And if you need more information on custom jigs and spins or BFish and tackles, ringworms, and H2O jigs, go to BFishandTackle.com. Till next time, Outdoor Junkies rule.
Right away, he's got a fish. Look at that.
Look at that thing.
Look at that fish. Is that a fish?
Oh,
nice.
That's my bait.
Nice one. Hit the jig. Not even a stinger pick.
He was born a year ago today.
Oh, look at that.
He's a monster.
Look at him.
He's like, man, I'll never hit a quarter ounce jig ever again.
Yep.